So today we're going to study about geography and tourism in United Arab Emirates, UAE, whatever we say. When I talk about United Arab Emirates, okay, it is a country which falls in the Middle East. And many of you, okay, you might have heard about Dubai, okay, Dubai City. Dubai, okay, many of the people, they get confused that with Dubai, that Dubai is a country. Dubai, it's not a country. Dubai, it's a city which falls in this United Arab Emirates. Okay, and when you talk about the capital city, Abu Dhabi. Okay, Abu Dhabi is the capital city of your United Arab Emirates. And Dubai, which is very popular tourism attractions from the United Arab Emirates, where it attracts millions of tourists towards it. Okay. So what we'll do in this, okay, we will talk about the geography of whole United Arab Emirates. And when you talk about tourism, I will concentrate only towards Dubai. Okay, I will not move to Abu Dhabi. So guys, can you able to see the map? Political map.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So you, if you can, okay, if you can see here, okay, your United Arab Emirates, okay, UAE, it is in the center part of your Middle East. Okay, although when you talk about the continent wise, it is in the Asia, but when you talk about IATA area wise, it is in the IATA area too. Okay. Here, the neighboring countries like your Yemen, Oman is the neighboring country. Then your then Saudi Arabia, Iran. So somewhat you can say, okay. And here, this is what your United Arab Emirates map. Okay. So the Tropic of Cancer, which is one of the important latitudinal line, which passes from your United Arab Emirates with 23 and half degree, okay, line that is. Okay. Towards the north of the United Arab Emirates, it is covered with the water body with your Persian Gulf. Okay. And here you can see your the major cities from United Arab Emirates are Dubai, Abu Dhabi, and Sharjah. Okay, Sharjah, Dubai, and Abu Dhabi. Okay, Abu Dhabi, which is the capital city, and Sharjah, it is also one of the prominent city from your United Arab Emirates, and Dubai, okay, which is also on the coastal northern coastal part of your United Arab Emirates. Okay, Persian Gulf at the water body. So that is what your Dubai is. Okay, when we talk about the tourism part, we will only concentrate about Dubai. Okay. So we'll move towards the basic information. As you know, when you talk about the continent wise, it is in the Asia, and when you talk about IATA area wise, it is in IATA area 2. Okay, IATA area 1, it includes your Northern America and Southern American continents. IATA area 2, it includes your Europe, it includes your Africa, and it includes your Middle East, that we have to remember. And Middle East, okay, in Middle East, your United Arab Emirates lies. Okay, so continent wise, it is in the Asia, and when you talk about IATA area wise, IATA area 2, then capital city is Abu Dhabi, and the largest city is Dubai, and currency is dirham. Okay, a currency of United Arab Emirates is dirham, and when you convert 1 dirham into Indian rupees, I think around 19 to 20 rupees you have to pay. Okay, 19 to 20 Indian rupee. If you pay, you will get 1 dirham of your United Arab Emirates. And official language is Arabic, and major cities, as I told you, Dubai, Abu Dhabi, and Sharjah. Neighboring countries, Oman and Saudi Arabia, they are the just bordering countries to your United Arab Emirates. And that is the area, okay. Very small area, they are having 83,600 square kilometer. And 9.1 million population this country has, and major religion is Islam. And time zone is +4. Okay, our Indian time zone is +5:30. It means they are 1.5 hour behind to us. Okay, 1.5 hour. It means 1.5 hour, approximate 1 o'clock there now. Okay, 1:12. Okay, in the afternoon. Then tourism tagline, discover all that is possible. And longitude wise, okay, it is in the eastern hemisphere from the GMT, 51 degree towards the east. Okay, and latitude wise, it is in the northern hemisphere, 22 degree to the north. Then when you talk about a little bit geography of this area, as I told you, this whatever United Arab Emirates you are having, guys, okay, it is there. One of the developed and wealthiest country, but whatever it has is it has only desert, guys. Okay, the whole country it has filled with the desert. Okay. And so this is again crude oil exporting company. This is a country, and don't get wrong with this country, okay, or Dubai. Okay, whatever the earning comes from crude oil, by exporting the crude oil, that is hardly 1 to 2%, guys. Okay, 98 to 99% of the earning of this country, it is dependent on the tourism sector. 98 to 99% of the earning of the Dubai, you can say, or United Arab Emirates, that is dependent on the tourism sector. So again, football is the major popular sports from this country. And Dubai, believe me, guys, United Arab Emirates, it doesn't has its own. It doesn't has water. It has to import the water from other countries. It doesn't has any crops. Okay, because whatever the land they get is desert land, guys. Okay, where you, it is not possible to grow. It is not allows for your agricultural activity. Even from all the agricultural products they buy from the other countries. Okay, they don't have water. They don't have your agricultural land. Then also they are one of the developed country in the world because of their visionary thoughts, guys. I will talk about that personality in later slide. Okay, and as I told you, okay, here and there, for geography part, okay, as I told you, this Gulf of Persia, okay, Persian Gulf, that is the neighboring water body, and apart from that, rivers and lakes, it doesn't has rivers and desert, rivers and your lakes, guys, okay, to name them, because in desert, as I told you, it is the deserty land, okay, in that you will not going to see the all those kind of thing. I have collected the highest point, okay, which is available, that is Jebel Ibir is the highest point which you're going to see in this country. And after that, as I told you, Tropic of Cancer, it has passed from here. You can see in the approximate in the center, Tropic of Cancer, it is passing. Okay, so next we'll move towards one of the leader who is the Prime Minister and King of this United Arab Emirates. Okay, so His Holiness Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid. Okay, so this personality, guys, this personality Dubai city, whatever it is today. Okay, because of his visionary thoughts. Okay, what he believes is, if you don't have money, if you that is okay, but if you don't have plan, if you don't have visionary kind of a thoughts, that is very wrong kind of a thing in his thoughts. Whatever he is the one man who thinks 10 to 20 years ahead. Okay, how our Dubai will be after 10 years, how my Dubai will be after 20 years. Okay, yeah, every time he plans for Dubai's wellness, Dubai's development part. Okay, although Dubai, it has whatever land it has got is deserty land. By using that desert land, he is developing Dubai like anything, guys. Okay, it is second most visited city in the world, guys, Dubai. Okay, more than that, population of Dubai, every day tourist visit to that. And believe me, guys, in the Dubai, whatever the population you will going to see today, more than 90% of the population who lives in the Dubai, they are not from Dubai or United Arab Emirates. They are from different countries. More or less from 200 countries, the people, they went over there and they have purchased the land and bungalows and they have settled down in this country because very low crime rate. Okay, they are very safest city to live. Okay, very luxury kind of a services you will get in Dubai. Okay, whatever the billionaires, whatever the crorepatis you will save from your country, they have their bungalows in the Dubai. Be it your Shah Rukh Khan, be it your Salman Khan, they are having their bungalows in the Dubai. Okay, whatever, whenever they get their free time, they go there and they enjoy this city. Okay, so that much of visionary things. Okay, that much of future plan, futuristic things that this leader has. Okay, this Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid. Okay, he is counted as one of the top 10 leaders. Okay, of the world, and he is the one. Okay, he is who is having different strategies. Okay, he thinks about different strategies to develop this nation. So when you talk about this guy, okay, I will tell you, okay, how they are developing this country and how they are making money. Okay, already I have told you, okay, they are not earning from their oil exports. They are majorly their income, it is based on the tourism sector. Okay, and okay, few of the interesting facts about this country is they levy heavy fines, guys. Okay, heavy fines will be levied on the people. They their intention is not to collect the fines from their citizens. They want to make their citizens, okay, who will be following rules and regulations. Okay, they want to make their citizens follow rules and regulations of their country. Okay, so I have added few of the fines, okay, which they collect in their country. Okay, when you talk about unjustified parking, okay, if you have parked in the place where parking is prohibited, okay, so the fine levied on you will be around 1,000 dirham, guys. Okay, 1,000 dirham, which when you convert into Indian rupee, it will be 20,000 rupee. Okay, 20,000 rupee you have to pay the penalty if you are parking your car in the where there is no parking is allowed. Okay, so again, for overspeeding, when you cross your red light. Okay, so see here, okay, exceeding your speed limit more than 60 kmph, 2000 dirham you have to pay the penalty. Okay, 2000 dirham, it is 40,000 rupees, 40,000 Indian rupees, guys. Okay, it is not a small amount. Okay, while when you drive a car, okay, driving a car along with talking in the mobile, you have to pay the penalty of 800 dirham. Like this, okay, heavy fines. Leave about this, okay, traffic fines. There is one example I will give you. Okay, although you are having your own car, okay, if you are not cleaning that car, and if you take your dirty car in the city, you will be penalized for that. Okay, for keeping your dirty cars. Okay, so again, you have to clean your you have to maintain cleanliness of your car. Again, you have to clean your cars in the designated areas. There are outlets to clean your cars. Okay, automated machines are there. You have to pay your money and you have to clean your cars. Okay, not like that, like in our India. Okay, we take a bucket of water and we clean our car and we make our roads dirty. They are not allowed for that. Okay, so that kind of for everything there is a penalty, guys. Okay, if you are a thief, they will cut your hands itself. And if you rape somebody, they will kill your you can understand that. Okay, that kind of a strict city this is. Okay, kissing in the public, it is not allowed. Okay, there are very strict rules one has to follow, okay, in this country. But very safest to live. Okay, that is the reason I told you earlier, 200 countries national people, that too the elite people of 200 countries, they have purchased their bungalows or flats in Dubai and they are living. Okay, so that is okay. And apart from that, okay, Dubai, whatever, believe me, guys, when you talk about Dubai, whatever the his name, okay, Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid. Okay, Sheikh Mohammed. Okay, whenever you talk about the Sheikh Mohammed, he will think differently, guys. Okay, whatever he wanted to make different things. Okay, it should be different from all the countries. If he wanted to make the artificial lake, he has made with love symbol. Okay, and this love lake, it is attracting n number of tourists. Okay, if you talk about our strategies, our minds, our people mindset, if you want to make the lake, then we will dig it in a round shape and we will make the artificial lake. But this guy, he is having somewhat different visionary, and he has made his artificial lake in the shape of heart, so that it has made he has kept the name as Love Lake, and this Love Lake, it is attracting n number of lovers towards it. Okay, and futuristic plans he has. Okay, he will not keep quiet by thinking today's plans are after 1 year, after 5 years, after 10 years. He is thinking far ahead, and he is planning to make bullet trains from Dubai to Mumbai. Okay, the plan already it has started. Okay, underwater bullet train project he has started already. He wanted to connect India with this Dubai, because guys, okay, forgive me if I am wrong, they know that, okay, all the labor class people, you will get it from the India. Okay, whatever the labor class people, they are working in the Dubai, are from India, or else from the Pakistan, or else from the Bangladesh, or else sometimes from Philippines. Okay, the labor class, the cleaners, sweepers, or construction workers, all they are from India or Pakistan or from Bangladesh or Philippines. Okay, so to connect this land, he is planning to make high speed trains. Okay, approximate 2000 kilometer length is, and underwater, guys. Okay, so this is again the futuristic plan of this guy, and he has started working on this. Okay, and apart from that, I have added other things. Okay, he has made the Dubai Miracle Garden. Okay, believe me, guys, by using the desert land, okay, he has thought to make a garden, that to flower garden he wanted to make, and he has made it world's biggest flower garden in his city, guys. World's biggest flower garden. His thought is either he wanted to make it as world's first or else world's largest. Okay, if it is not world's first, then he wanted to make it as world's largest. That kind of a visionary thoughts he has. So he wanted to make a flower garden, so he has made Dubai Miracle Garden. That is, Dubai Miracle Garden is the world's largest flower garden in the world. And yeah, so as I told you, Dubai, whatever area it has, very small area they have, so he has started to utilize that beach, and he is converting that as the islands. Okay, so again, okay, so when you make this artificial islands, okay, so again in that artificial islands, he is by his visionary thoughts, what he has done, he has made that visionary that island in the palm tree shape. Okay, because again he was having a strategy here. Okay, palm tree shape alli madidha kaarana yen antandre, here you can see in the image, he has kept, okay, whatever the leaves you are seeing here, okay, in that area, he has few of the tree, he has grown the trees, and he has made the bungalows. Okay, when you try to purchase the bungalows, everyone they wanted to purchase the sea facing bungalows. So by knowing that strategy, he has made this island in this shape, and whatever the two side bungalows he has made, okay, each the side they will get the sea face. So for single bungalow in this palm island, it will cost you around 200 to 250 crores. That much of amount they are paying, and they are purchasing the land here. So that is what the different strategy what he has, guys. Okay, so apart from that, okay, palm island, okay, that is to give the housing to the people. He has constructed the bungalows here, and he has sold to the world people. And believe me, guys, here they will, okay, if you want to purchase 200 crore property there, they will not collect a single rupee from you as the tax, as the government. Okay, here in India, okay, why our country is not developing in the FDI, foreign direct investment? Here, for everything you have to pay the taxes. Here, for everything you have to wait for your 6 months, one year for your clearance of your documents. Okay, ease of governance, somewhere we are failing. But in the Dubai, this provides you the ease of documentation, all those kind of a thing. Okay. And okay, policing. Okay, I left the adding those images. The world's richest police, you will going to see in this Dubai. Okay, the police of Dubai, they use Audi car to roam in their city, guys. Okay, and whatever the complaint, this is again, there will you will not. Okay, when I talk about again richest, don't take me wrong as they are corrupt police. There you will not see the zero rupee corruption in the policing, because whatever the complaint handling system, it is go online. Okay, just you have to feed your information in the system, that's it. Okay, you, the police, they will take care of everything. Okay, so that kind of a government governance these people are running. And here one of the attraction again in Dubai is your Dubai Land. Okay, Universal Studio, that is. Okay, these people, they wanted to make the they wanted to actually this king, okay, Prime Minister Mohammed, he wanted to make the Disneyland here. Okay, so he approached the USA people, the Disneyland, that is the project of your Dubai, right? He has approached the Dubai people, USA people, to make their one Disneyland in Dubai. And he put a condition, that condition was, I need a Disneyland which is bigger than your USA. So in that case, that Disneyland people, they have rejected his request. Okay, they said that we will not make bigger than our USA's Disneyland University. So that's why what he has made, again, he has made his own land, that is Universal Studio, that is Dubai Land. Now Dubai Land, it is 2.5 bigger than your whatever the US is, the Disneyland. Okay, that kind of a visionary these people are having. Okay, whatever the yearly tourist we receive in India, one day tourist, they enter into the Dubai Land. So that kind of a tourism they have developed. And whatever the desert they are having, they have converted it into tourism attractions, and desert safaris are provided to the tourist. Okay, if you want camel safari, you will get it, or if you want the jeep safari, if you want the luxury car safari, that you will get, or if you want to ride the ATV, all-terrain vehicle ride, you will get it. Okay. And yeah, so apart from that, we'll talk about the few of the tourism attractions. Okay, there are plenty of tourism attractions in Dubai. Okay, if you want to stay there for 8 days, you can stay in Dubai. Okay, I have added few of the tourism attractions here that we will going to study. First one, okay, which I have added here is Burj Al Arab. Okay, Burj Al Arab. Again, when you talk about the Burj Al Arab, as I told you, they wanted to make it as the first or the largest. Burj Al Arab, it is the only 7-star hotel in the world. Okay, apart from this, you will not going to see the 7-star hotels in the world. Okay, whatever the hotels you will going to see, that is hardly 5-star hotels. Okay. So this Dubai, it has the Burj Al Arab as this only 7-star hotel in this country. And it has 202 suite rooms in this, and many of the items inside this Burj Al Arab, they are made up of gold. Okay, even your washroom, in washroom also you will get few of the amenities with your gold. Okay, and open for the tourist since from 1999. Okay. So that is the height of Burj Al Arab is 689 feet. Then next one is, again, the next highest is Burj Khalifa, guys. Okay, Burj Khalifa. When you talk about this Burj Khalifa, this is the tallest building in the world. Okay, Burj Khalifa, again, it has made its history as the tallest building in the world, with the height of 2,722 feet. Okay, if you want it in meters, that is 829.8 meters height. Okay, and what they have made in this Burj Khalifa, they have made residential houses and the offices. They have rented it, okay, from single house. They have collected more than 200-300 crore rupees. Okay, so from that also, they have provided the, they have sold their houses. Okay, whatever the blocks they have made, they have sold their offices, office outlets, and they have made the lifetime attraction for their country. See their visionary thoughts. They have made a gallery here. Okay. So that gallery, again, from that gallery, you can see the beauty of Dubai. Okay. So that attracts, again, this is ticketed monument. And Burj Khalifa, it has n number of records to its name. Okay, when you talk about the records, this Burj Khalifa, it has the record of tallest building in the world. It has the record of highest number of stories in the world, building stories, highest occupied floors in the world, and highest outdoor observation deck in the world. Then tallest service elevator in the world. Okay, tallest lift in the world, this Burj Khalifa has. Okay, so these are the few world records. Okay, apart from this, it has a number of records to its name. In front of your Burj Khalifa, you will going to see the Dubai Fountain. Okay, Dubai Fountain, that is water fountain they have made, and this water fountain, it attracts a number of tourists in the night. Okay, it is the musical dance. Okay, music, rain dance. Okay, that kind of a thing. Okay, which is very attractive for the tourist. Okay, next is Dubai Mall. Okay, when you talk about again Dubai Mall, it is the world largest one. Again, it has hotels, it has restaurants, it has a big luxury brand outlets, it has a rainforest cafe, it has a cinema theaters where 22 screens can be seen. Okay, 22 screens in one cinema hall. Okay, it has a underwater aquarium, it has a underwater zoo. It has the kidziana. Okay, that is the children's play area. Okay. So again, it has made ski Dubai, guys. Okay, as we say, okay, we are having the Himalayan mountains for this snowy thing. They have made that snowy land, artificial snowy land in their city itself. Okay, that ski Dubai, they have maintained this snow. Okay, by maintaining the temperature that is -1 to 2 degrees. Okay, they maintain that snow, and in that snow you can enjoy the snow based adventure activities. Okay, so that kind of people these are. Okay, in that where outside temperature is around 45 to 50 degree, okay, average, in that Dubai city they have made this ski Dubai, guys. Okay, by maintaining the temperature, because that ski related atmosphere, the ski related activities, they wanted to serve to their city people. Okay, so that is why they have made this ski Dubai also. After that, they have Dubai Gold Souk, which is the world's largest gold market. Okay, world's largest gold market, you will get it in Dubai. Okay, so in that in this Dubai Gold Souk, you will going to see 380 retailers. Okay, where they are selling different variety of the gold items. Okay, so this is what Dubai, guys. Okay, so by this I conclude a class on United Arab Emirates. Okay, my focus, I have mainly focused towards your Dubai city, and I think I have forgot regarding the visa. When you talk about the visa, so for Indian citizens, it is Dubai, that is United Arab Emirates, they are providing e-visa, electronic visa. By sitting in your home itself, you can apply for Dubai visa. No need to approach to the travel agents. Okay, just whatever the documents you need is around, I think you need your passport. Okay, in that passport you should need 2 to 3 page empty pages. Okay, passport, 2 to 3 empty pages. You need your passport size photograph. Now it is again digitalized, you have to scan or you have to take the selfie. That's it. And you have to pay the online fees. Okay, yeah, the visa fee, it will be vary from season to season. Okay, from 6,000 to 10,000 around. Okay, just you have to visit the website. Okay, in Make My Trip website also you can go there, and you can directly apply over there. Okay, just few steps. Okay, you have to fill it out your personal details from the passport. You have to scan your front page of your passport. You have to scan your last page of your passport. You have to take a selfie of your front face, 80% face coverage, and you have to pay online amount, and you, within 5 to 6 working days you will get your United Arab Emirates tourist visa, that too for 30 days. So very, very easy process you are having as the Indian citizen. So that is about, we have to learn. Okay, we have to learn a lot of things from this Dubai or United Arab Emirates. Okay, so any doubts, guys? Any doubts you are having in this?
No, sir.
Just can you answer these questions quickly? which is the capital city of United Arab Emirates?
Abu Dhabi.
IATA area?
2.
Very good. Official language? Urdu,
Arabic.
India. Arabic, very good. Currency? Dirham, Riyal, Dollar.
UAE, Dirham.
Yeah, UAE. Option. Yeah, yeah, very, very good, guys. Very good. And Tropic of Cancer, okay, which lies over UAE. It lies at 23.5 degrees north of the equator, guys. Okay. Name the world's first 7-star hotel. Burj Al Arab, Burj Khalifa, Taj Hotel, Leela Palace.
Al Arab.
Burj Al Arab. Very good, guys. Yeah. Very good. No doubts then? No doubts?
No,
okay,
sir.
Okay. Can anyone take me the screenshot for me?
No, sir.
Attendance screenshot. Can anyone send me? Harsha, Nirali, anyone?
Harsha will send, sir.
Okay, but yes, okay. Thank you for your patience listening. See you next class. Thank you.